Hi, good morning. Yesterday class we discussed regarding operators. Already we discussed arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, assignment operators, and bitwise operators. And bitwise operators already we discussed. Bitwise and bitwise OR, exclusive OR. Okay. Already we discussed. Now we are going to discuss left shift and right shift. Okay, so how to open the terminal? So go to Python folder, so Python, so click on IDLA. So this is the IDLA. Here you need to type the programs. So these programs are not saved in the system. Whenever we close the IDLA, automatically the written key also vanish. So if you want to store the programs, if you want to save the programs in your system, then you need to use the PyCharm. Okay, so into left shift operator. Left shift, suppose 10, left shift 2. So here you will get output is 40. So how the left shift operator internally processes? Here 10 is the value. So what about the 2? 2 means positions to move the true bits in this value. Suppose if you want to define this decimal value into binary number, first of all you have to design this decimal number into binary number. So how to define it? So already yesterday we discussed 10 binary number is 1010. Again I am repeating, if you want to convert decimal number into binary number, so you have to do like this, to 5 remainder 0, 2 times remainder 1, 2 1 time remainder 0. So from bottom to top 1010. So in this binary number, it is having only true bits to this one and this one. So here these two indicates only true bits positions, only true bits, and this one move to left side, not right side. Here we are using left shift operator. Suppose here a point is there, this and these are left shift means we are losing the bits. Simply before the decimal point you need to put the two zeros, 1010 0 0. So that's all. So now we have to convert this binary number into a decimal number, and this one is the 2 to the power of 0, and this one is the 2 to the power of 1, and this one is the 2 to the power of 2, and this one is the 2 to the power of 3. 2 to the power of 3 means 8 plus, and this one is the 2 to the power of 4. So but this one is the 2 to the power of 5. 2 to the power of 5 means 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 are 32. So 32 plus 8. So you see, so 40 is there. So this is the left shift operator. Okay. Suppose if I specify 10, left shift 3. So this is the answer. Suppose 1010 decimal point. Here I specified three positions to move. So these two bits are transferred to left side, three positions. So how to convert it? Simply specify 1010. Simply you need to put here three zeros. Suppose if you say four bits, you need to in left shift operator, we are gaining the bits. Before the decimal point, we are gaining the bits. Simply you have to specify the three bits. Now you have to convert into a decimal number. So this is the left shift operator. Okay. So next, coming to the right shift operator. So 10, right shift 2. So here, what the output we will get? 2. So how internally right shift operator is processed? Already we know 10 binary number is 1010. So decimal point and zeros. So remember that in left shift operator, we are gaining the bits. But in right shift operator, we are losing the bits. Here I specified 2. These two bits are moved to right side. Simply these two are we are losing. Simply you can say finally we will get 10. Remember that in left shift operator we are gaining the bits, and right shift operator we are losing the bits. So here finally we got 10. So here 2 to the power of 0 and 2 to the power of 1, 2 to the power of 1. So what is the output? So 2. Suppose if I say 10, right shift operator 3. You see here the output is 1. How it is happened? 10, 10, decimal point 0. So in right shift operator we are losing the bits. How many bits we are losing? 3 bits. So finally 1. Okay, so 2 to the power of 0, this one. 2 to the power of 0 is 1, 1 into 1, 1. So finally you will get 1. Okay, that's all about the operator. So these are all about the operators in the Python. So how many types of operators are available in the Python? Arithmetic operators, logical operators, relational operators, assignment operators, okay, and bitwise operators. And next topic is, now we are going to discuss operator precedence. Now we are going to operator precedence. Suppose if any expression contains combination of operators, how the expression is evaluated? Suppose 2 plus 3 by 4. So this is the expression. In this expression, so it contains two operators. One is addition operators and another one is divide operator. How the expression is evaluated? So first priority goes to which operator? Either plus or divide. So in Python, you can say does, pem does. So operator precedence is based on pem does. Pem does means, P means parenthesis, E means exponential, M means multiplication, D means division, A means addition, S means subtraction. So in this way, operator precedence is evaluated in the Python. Okay, so in this expression, the first priority, first evaluated is 3 by 4. After that, the obtained result value is added to this value. So this is called operator precedence. Once again, I'm repeating, in Python, operator precedence is based on PEMDAS. PEMDAS means, P means first priority goes to parentheses, after that exponential, after that multiplication, after that division, after that addition, after that subtraction. So this is called operator precedence. So now we will check how the operator precedence is evaluated. The same expression is 2 plus 3 by 4. So first it evaluated 3 by 4. After that 2 plus 0.75. Okay, so in this way. But I want to first add 2 plus 3. After that we have to divide that value by 4. So how it is evaluated? Simply you can put the parenthesis by 4. So in this, first it evaluates the this 2 plus 3 because parenthesis. So 2 plus 3 5, next by 4. Okay, so you will get output 1.0. See the difference. So this is called operator precedence. Suppose if you see 2 power 3 plus 4, okay, by 1. Okay, so in this expression, first it evaluates the 2 power 3. After that, it evaluates the 4 by 1. So both obtained results are added finally. So finally you will get the output 12.0. So this is called operator precedence. Okay. Okay, and the next topic is number system. So number system. So number system, we have four types of number system. One is decimal number, so 0 to 9 and base is 10. Okay, next, binary number, only 0s 1 and base is 2. Next, octal number system, 0 to 7, base is 8. Next, hexadecimal number system, 0 to 9 and A to F. Finally, you can say 0 to 15. Their base is 16. So this is the number system. Okay. Suppose here I declared variable A. It contains the value 25. I need to convert into binary number. So how it is? Already I told you, if you want to convert decimal to binary number system, in the manual process, you need to do like this, 12 times 1 and 2, 6 times and 0 and 2, 3 times and 0, so 2, 1 time 1. So finally 11001. This is the manual process, but in Python already one inbuilt function is available. So that is nothing but bin. So what is the function name? Bin. So bin of A, simply you specify. So 11001, this is the binary number of a given decimal number. So what about this prefixed value 0b? 0b means it's a binary number. So binary number prefixed with 0b. So if you want to convert any number, for example, bin of 4. So 4 binary number is 100. So it is prefixed with 0b. 0b means, b means binary number. Suppose if you want to convert bin of 8. Yeah, so 8 means 1000. Suppose if you want to convert any number, any decimal number, 1010. So this is the function, inbuilt function bin. You have to pass argument. Okay, automatically it converts given decimal number into binary number. Suppose if you see here, I have given the binary number, so automatically it reverses it. It converted into decimal number. How it is converted? 1010. So 2 to the power of 0, 2 to the power of 1, 2 to the power of 1, 2 plus 2 to the power of 2, 2 to the power of 3. 2 to the power of 3 is 8. You see, 2 plus 8, so the result is 10. Okay. Suppose I want to convert this decimal into 10 decimal number into octal. So the function name is oct. So the pass. So final obtained value is 12. What about this value? 0O. 0O. 0O means, O means octal. Okay. Suppose if you see oct of 23. So the final result is 27. Suppose if you want to convert oct of 12, so 0O14. Okay, if you want to convert any number into octal format, simply use the oct function. If you want to convert any number into binary format, simply use the bin functions. Suppose if you want to convert any number into hexadecimal, okay, simply use hex. X of 10. Simply you see, yeah. Already I told you 0 to 15, 0 to 9 numbers and A to F. So here it is prefixed with 0x. X means hexadecimal. Suppose if you want to convert hex of 15. So 0x F. And x of 20, so 0x14. Okay, so if you want to convert a number into binary number, use the binary function. If you want to convert any number into octal, use the octal function. If you want to convert a number into hexadecimal, use the hex function. Okay, suppose if you want to convert to variable values into complex type, simply use the complex function. Suppose A equals to 10 and B equals to 20. Okay. So C equals to complex of A comma B. So complex function takes two arguments. Okay, if you see, print the C, See that C is a complex data type. Okay, so complex means it contains real and imaginary. Automatically, complex function converts the given arguments into complex type. Okay, that's all about the number system. Okay, and the next we are going to discuss type conversion. Now we are going to discuss type conversion. Type conversion means converting one type to another type. Okay, suppose I want to convert into to float. Suppose I want converted to into to string. Suppose I want to convert float to int. Okay. So this is called type conversion. So if you want to perform type conversion, suppose if you see x equals to red, I need to convert this x into float. So then you can use which function? Float. You need to go on the graph x. You see the final derived output is 100. So actually x value is 100. Whenever I use the float function, so it automatically converts the integer type into float. Suppose if I want to convert, for example, float value. So this is the float value. Suppose I want to cut into integer value, simply use the int function, int of y. So it converted into integer value. Okay. So after decimal point of that value is removed by the int function. It considers only before the decimal point value. It omits the after decimal point value. Okay. Suppose here I declared sum b equals to 200. So actually this is the integer value, but I need to convert it into string. So if you want to convert this integer value into string, you need to use str function, str of b. Whenever I use str of b, so it is converted into string. Here you observe single quotes. Okay, so suppose convert it into integer value, simply can use which function? Int of here. Whenever we say this string, string means not characters, numbers, but this integer number is defined as a string. Automatically it converts it into integer value. Okay. So I think already we discussed the number system and we discussed the type test. Converting means converting one type to another type. If you want to convert any integer value into float, simply use the float function. If you want to convert any float value into integer, simply use the int function. If you want to convert any integer value into string, use the str function. If you want to convert any string into integer, use the integer function. Suppose if you see a equals to high, but this is a string. Okay. If I try to convert this as an integer, You see, so automatically throws an error exception. So value error. Okay. It won't allow us to convert characters into integer. So it allows only numbers. Okay. Remember that. Okay. That's all about the type conversion. Okay. So now we are going to discuss in Python how to print the result value and how to display a message. Okay. So in Python, if you want to display a message or a value, use print function. Print is the inbuilt function which prints a given value or a message. Okay. How to do this one? Suppose here I am declaring a equals to 10, b equals to 20, c equals to a plus b. Okay. Simply use the print of c. You see, print function automatically displays the result value. Suppose if you want to display this value along with the message, simply use print. Message should be enclosed with the double quotes, and this is the message. Comma is the concatenation operator. We are concatenating the variable value. So if you see, the final result is some value. Okay. So print is an inbuilt function which prints a message along with the value. If you want to print a value along with the message, use the comma. So comma is the concatenation operator. Okay. Suppose if you see here x equals to 100. Okay. Suppose what happened when you define these statements. If you see, so for example, if it is a RAM, okay. Here x, okay, it contains value 200. Okay, so but this x is created in the RAM, but it contains some memory address. Suppose that memory address is some 1 2 3 4, like that. Okay, so this x is created in the RAM. Okay, this x value is the 200, but this x variable memory address is it's a sample 1 2 3 4. Suppose if you want to find this memory address of this x variable, so that is possible in the Python. If you want to find the memory address of the given variable, given identifier, simply use the id function. Id is the inbuilt function. Here you need to pass identifier, variable name. Okay, so this is the memory address. Okay, this is the memory address of the x. Okay, now I am declaring another variable y equals to 200. What happens? Okay, in memory another variable is created. That variable name is y. Okay, that y value equals to 200. Okay, now we need to find the address of this variable. Simply use id of Y. So this is the memory address. Okay, if you see, both are different, not same. So this is the Y memory address. This is the Y memory address. Clearly observe. So both memory addresses are different. Here X 200. Simply you can say sorry. Here the X value is 100, not 200. Okay. So both variables are created in the memory in different addresses. X is the 100 and Y equals 200. Suppose here I created another variable Z equals to 200. Okay, what will happen? Is it going to create another address or other? It is pointing to this variable in Python. Whenever the variable contains the same value, it won't create different memory address. Okay, so I will show you. Suppose here Z is created. Z, but it is contained 200 same value, so it points to same memory address. Okay, it points to same memory address because Y contains and Z contains the same value. Okay, so if you check, so address of the Z identifier, you see the same memory address is created. So that is the beauty of the Python programming language. So it is called memory management. Okay, it won't create the another memory address. Okay, that's all about the memory addresses. If you want to find address of the any given variable, so use which function? ID function. Suppose here I am going to create some S equals to welcome. So here I created welcome. Suppose if I want to find the ID of that S, so this is the ID memory address. Here I am creating another variable with the same content, welcome, the same content. But S1 also having the same memory address. If you want to check that one, so ID of S1, you see, observe that both variables having the same memory address. Okay, so this is called memory concept, memory addressing concept. Suppose if you want to find the type of the variable, okay, simply use type function. So ID function use it to find the memory address of the identifier and type. Suppose if I use type of X, so if you see X type is int. So int class, we will discuss about the regarding class later. Okay. Suppose here I declared some Q equals to 23.45. So I need to find the type of this variable. Simply use type of Q. So this type is float. Suppose if you want to find the type of the S variable, simply use the type of S. So here S type is str. Suppose if you want to suppose 2 + 3j, if you want to find the type of this C variable, type C. So C is which type? Complex type, Remember that complex type means it contains real and real and imaginary. Okay. Suppose if you want to find the type of this variable, simply use type of the f. So this type is bool. Suppose false, sorry, false type of v. Okay, so boolean type. Okay, so that's all about the id function as well as the type function. But if you see here, I typed so many lines of code. If I close this IDLE automatically, all the written code is also vanished. So all the written code is vanished. So you need to use IDE, PyCharm IDE, to store the programs. Already I told you, if you want to do the same thing, so right click, new Python file, simply say test 10, whatever it is. Okay, here simply equals to 100 id of a. Okay, simply use print function. So print, if you want to find the type of a, simply right click and run. See, here you will get output. So yeah, this is the memory address. So a type is integer type. Here I am declaring another variable. Again I am repeating some welcome. If you want to find the ID and type of this as, okay, simply use ID of as and type of as. Okay, if you run this, okay, so observe that. So this is the memory address of the as, and this is the type. Okay, so that's all about the ID and type. So ID and types are inbuilt functions. Okay, suppose if you want to add another file, so right click on src, new Python file, some test file, something. Okay, so if you want to perform any operations, simply can say equals to 10, b equals to 20, print sum is comma a plus b. Suppose if you want to perform difference operation, difference is a minus b. If you want to perform multiplication, a into b. So if you want to perform, so division, okay, a by b. So you can use colon. Okay, so if you run this program, you see, you will get the output. Sum is, division is, multiplication is, and division is. Okay, so my suggestion is to all write programs in the PyCharm IDE. Okay. So that's all for today. Today we discussed about what topics already we discussed. Bitwise operators. Next, number system. Okay, right. Type conversion and predefined functions like ID and type. Okay. So again, I am opening the Python IDLE. Suppose here I am declaring A equals to 10, B equals to 20. If you want to perform swap operation, so we need to transfer B value to A, we need to transfer A value to B. How it is happened? So already you know temp equals to A. First of all, I'm transferring A value to temp variable. So next, now A is empty. Okay, now I'm transferring B value to A. Okay, now B is empty. So now I'm transferring temporary variable value to B. If you print A, you see values are changed. If you see B, values are changed. So this is called swap operation. Okay. Suppose here I am declaring x equals to 23, y equals to 42. Okay, so there is another simple mechanism to swap these values. How it is possible? X comma y equals to y comma x. Simple, in single line we swap the variable values. Okay, if you print x, you see x value is 42. If you print y value is 23. So this is called swapping in Python. Compared to other programming language, it's very easy to perform code in the Python. Is simple. So that is the beauty of the Python programming language. Suppose you can declare like that. Suppose a comma bb equals to 12 comma 23. So this is the one type of variable declaration. Here AA captures, AA stores this 12 value and BB stores this 23 value. Suppose if you print AA, okay, and if you print BB, okay, so it displays the value. Okay, so that's all about the today's class. Okay, and tomorrow we are going to discuss new topics. Already all of you aware of it, control statements and next strings. These topics tomorrow we are going to discuss, control statements and strings. Okay, that's all for today's class.